Hello friends, my name is Dr. Puru Dhawan, and in this video I will try my level best to make you understand what are the causes of kidney failure, because it's very important for all kidney failure patients to understand the cause of kidney failure in their cases. Because if you know the cause of your kidney failure, you can simply control that cause and you can control the progression of this disease. So in this video I will explain the causes and how to identify the cause of kidney failure in your case. So let's get started. So let's start with the common causes of kidney failure. 80% of the cases of kidney failure comes with the complaint of either hypertension or diabetes. So if we want to control the progression of this kidney failure disease, we have to control the causes first. What happens? Because of high pressure impact of blood with the wall of the tissues, it causes hardening of that tissue. This causes sclerosis of the cells of the kidney. Because of sclerosis, what happens? That part of tissue loses its functions, and when the function loses, the kidney is unable to filter out the blood properly, and the level of creatinine starts increasing in the body, because now the creatinine is unable to excrete it out. So if we want to control this progression of disease, now whatsoever damage has happened is happened. Now if we want to control the progression of the disease, we have to control the cause of the kidney failure, and that is your hypertension. Now once your hypertension is in control, there will be no further damage to your kidney and your creatinine level will remain stable. Same thing happen with the cases of diabetic nephropathy, where the cause of kidney failure is your high sugar levels. What happens in the body when the sugar level rises above 200, kidney starts filtering sugar from the body out. In such cases, kidney works as a pressure valve to control the sugar level in the body. But when the kidney performs this function over and over, what happens? Because of high sugar level in the body, because of this overload of the kidney starts losing its function. And when the function of the kidney become low, what happens? The level of creatinine, level of urea, level of potassium start increasing in the body. So if we want to control the level of creatinine in the body, if we want to control the progression of kidney disease, we have to control the diabetes first. Only then we can control the progression of this disease. So we have to understand the causes of kidney failure first. Now let's move to the identification of the cause of kidney failure in your case. If you have a history of hypertension and your ultrasound shows shrinkage of the kidney, that means your kidney is shrink because of your hypertension. You are suffering from kidney failure because of your hypertension. And if you have a history of diabetes and your kidney size is normal, texture is normal, that means you are suffering from diabetic nephropathy. Your kidney is getting damaged because of your high level of sugar. So if you control these causes, you can control the progression of this disease. And if your ultrasound shows multiple amount of cyst over your kidney, that means your kidney is suffering from kidney failure disease because of polycystic kidney. And if biopsy is done and biopsy shows some kind of deposition, Ig deposition over kidney, that means you are suffering from kidney failure because of Ig nephropathy. So these are the major causes of kidney failure: hypertension, diabetes, polycystic kidney and Ig nephropathy. Now with the help of your ultrasound report, you can simply make yourself assessment and you can make what are the cause of kidney failure in your case. Now let's move to its control. If we want to control the level of creatinine, if we want to control the waste material in body, we can do this by two ways. Either we have to cut down the production of the waste material in the body, or we can increase the excretion of waste material from the body. At Science Engineering, we work on both ways. We start with the diet. With the help of diet, we can control each and every element in the body. We can control the level of creatinine, we can control the level of potassium in the body. To control the level of creatinine, we advise all kidney failure patients to avoid all kind of protein, because when the person take high amount of protein, what happens? The production of creatinine in the body also increases, and the level of creatinine increases because the kidney is not filtering well. And we advise all kidney failure patients to avoid all kind of vigorous exercise, because this creatinine is a protein which is produced in our muscle as a waste material. So if we want to cut down its production, we have to control the metabolism of the muscle, and the exercises increases the metabolism of the muscles. So if a patient suffer from fever and he do lots of exercises and takes lots of protein, what happens is that the production of the creatinine increases, that results in higher level of creatinine. So we can control level of creatinine with the right amount of diet. So we have to cut down all kind of protein from dairy products, protein from pulses, protein from meat, non-veg, chicken, fish, eggs, so that body produces lesser amount of creatinine. And we have to avoid fever, because when person suffer from fever, what happens? Because of muscles fatigue, creatinine production increases, and we have to avoid all kind of vigorous exercises, because as the metabolism of the muscle increases, production of creatinine also increases. So we have to take care of all these things just to control the level of creatinine in the body. We can control potassium also with the help of diet, because whatever we eat contains potassium. It contains, either it contains in the low amount or in the high amount. So we have to choose those food products which contains potassium in low amount naturally. So we have to select. So now I will explain how can we can choose low potassium food items. In case of fruits, we have to avoid banana, kiwi, avocado, dry fruits and dates, coconut water. And we have to limit the portion size of the fruits. If we want to take apple, we have to take only one apple. We can't exceed the amount of fruits more than one cup. So we can take either one cup of papaya or one apple. That is fruits. Now let's move to the vegetables. If we move to the vegetable, what we see is that any vegetable which is grown below the surface of earth, like potato, turnip, sweet potatoes, these food items contains large amount of high potassium naturally. So we have to avoid all these food items. And leafy vegetables like mustard, spinach, coriander, mint contains high amount of potassium. So we have to avoid all these food items. Now, any vegetable which is grown as a fruit on a plant or creeper can be taken, like brinjal, tomatoes, bitter ground, round ground, snake ground, any food item which is as a grown as a fruit can be taken. Now let's move to the cereals and see what cereals you can take. We have to take wheat or rice. If you are non-diabetic, you can take both wheat and rice, and if you are diabetic, avoid rice. In case of wheat, we can take any derivative of wheat. Wheat can be taken as a dalia, wheat can be taken as a maida, wheat can be taken as a bread, wheat can be taken as a cookies. So any form of wheat is allowed to a kidney failure patient. Same thing with the rice. Rice can be taken as a poha, rice can be taken as a cooked rice and sticky rice. Rice can be taken with any kind of vegetable, low potassium vegetable. If your patient take care of the diet, patient can control the level of potassium and creatinine very easily. This kind of diet helps patient to control the production of the creatinine. Now we can also control the level of creatinine with the help of increasing the excretion of the creatinine from the body. To that, so we have to increase the kidney function. We have to increase the filtration of the blood. For that purpose, at Science Engine, we advise all kidney failure patients to go for kidney function restoration treatment. Now I will explain how kidney function restoration treatment works. Kidney function restoration treatment works in three ways. First, it will control the cause of kidney failure. Suppose you are suffering from kidney failure because of your hypertension. This treatment will help you to control the level of hypertension in your body, because without controlling hypertension, we can't control the progression of disease and we can't control the level of creatinine in the body. So first step is to control the cause of kidney failure. In second step of kidney function restoration treatment, it will help kidney to restore its function, and the function of the kidney is to control the level of creatinine, level of urea, level of potassium in the body. For that purpose, we have to increase its filtration power. With the help of Ayurvedic medicine, with the help of renal tonics, we can increase the function of the kidney. Suppose your kidney is working with the efficacy of 40%, and when we start kidney function restoration treatment, what happens? The filtration power of the kidney increases, and as the excretion of the creatinine increases, the level of creatinine in your body decreases. And that was the motive, that was the aim, that was the function of kidney function restoration treatment. And when the cause of the kidney failure is in control and the level of creatinine is in control, what happens? Body starts healing itself, kidney starts making adjustment in itself. That results in much better efficacy of kidney in a long run. So that was the kidney function restoration treatment that helps patient to restore its functions, helps patient to control the level of creatinine, urea, potassium in the body. If you have any question regarding kidney function restoration treatment, kidney failure, you can simply ask on the number given below. You can also book an appointment with me on the same number. You can also visit our website sciencekidneycare.com for further information. With this, allow me to say goodbye. See you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.